Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to welcome all of you to the wonderful world of mathematics and MathCon Universe. Today, our focus will be on the laws of exponents and its related examples. I repeat, our focus will be on what? The laws of exponents and its related examples. As you already know, the laws of exponents is one of the most important laws in algebra. It has so many great applications in algebra and other areas of mathematics. Our goal today will be to break down this law as well as the related examples, to break down these laws one by one and give you the related examples. So what is the starting point for this presentation? What will be our logical starting point for this presentation? Where do we really begin to make such a very critical presentation? Well, the first thing we want to do is to emphasize the conditions connected to the laws of exponents. I repeat, the conditions connected to the laws of exponents. What are the conditions? We want to let x, y, and z represent any real number. Also, we want to let m, n, and t represent any integer from the real number line. So, once we have this condition, now we are ready to go into the main law. So laws of exponents and what? Laws of exponents and its related examples. So what are the laws of exponents and its related examples? What are they? What are these important laws? Law number one states that if x is raised to the power m, where again we noted that x is any real number and n is an integer, and we take another exponential expression x to the n, this law says that we can keep the base x and then add the powers m and n. As you know, x is the base and m is the power or exponent. And of course, x is a base again and n is a power exponent. So it says whenever we multiply two exponential expressions with different powers, but the same base, say keep the base and add the powers. So an example of this, of course, will be of this form. If you have x to the sixth power times x to the seventh power, this law says keep the base x and add the powers 6 plus 7. Again, keep the base, which is x, and add the powers, 6 and 7 respectively. And then this is going to give us what? X to what? Well, 6 plus 7, anybody?
13.
13. Thank you, Ms. Lemon of Houston, Texas. 13. So this will give us x to the 13th power. Okay? So now we go and examine the law of exponents. Number two, what is law of exponent number two? Law of exponent number two says, if you take x, which is considered the base in this case, and raise it to the power m, and now instead of multiplication, we go ahead and divide by x to the power n, the law says what? You're going to take just one of the base, x, and do what? What do we do now? Instead of adding two powers, what do? Subtract. Let me thank you very much. So we do m minus n. So when you divide, you just keep the base and subtract the powers. So that means that what? If you have an example like this, x to the fifth power divided by x to the third power, according to this law, says we can just keep, again, the base, one of the base, and now do what? Subtract. So that would be 5 minus 3. So we'll keep one of the base, subtract the powers. So what would be 5 minus 3 in this case? 2. So that would be x to the second power. X to the second power. Now, law number 3 is fairly straightforward. What does law number 3 says? Let's see. Law number 3 says you take one of the exponential expression x to the m and raise it to power n. Sometimes this law is known as the power of a power. Don't confuse this law with law number 1. See? So that means we're going to do what with this? We're going to take the x to the m and now multiply what? It by n. So we keep the base, one of the base, and then multiply the powers, exponents. So that means what? That if we have an example like this that's similar, where we have x, to the sixth power, and then we are called to raise this to the third power. According to this law of exponent, what we must do is do what? Do x to the sixth power times 3. X to the 6th power times 3. So that would be what? What is 6 times 3?
18.
So that would be X to the 18th power. That would be X to the 18th power. Miss Lemon of Houston, Texas, thank you very much. So that would be X to the 18th power. X to the 18th power. So what will be the next law? The next law is the law of exponent number 4. Law of exponent number 4. Sometimes we call this L4 or law of exponent number 4. So what will be the law of exponent number 4? What does it say? What do we do with law of exponent? How does it work? How does this law of exponent number 4 work? Law of exponent number 4, L4. Well, law of exponent number 4 says what? If you have x to the m times y to the n, and then you put this inside and open and close parentheses, and raise it to power t. Okay, remember again that x and y are real numbers from the real number line, and then the m and n are integers, and of course the t is an integer as well. According to this important law number 4, it says we can take x to the m multiply by t, and then take y to the n multiply this by t. Okay? Take x to the m multiply by t
take what is n, multiply by t. So example, of course, is appropriate now. What will be an example for this? Let's look at the example closely. So if you have something like here, 2x to the 4th power times y to the 6th power, and you're asked to raise everything to a 2nd power, what do you think the answer will be for this law? Can anybody tell me? If I have a situation like this, can anybody tell me what the solution will be? Yes. If you're given something like this, what do you think would happen if I use this law number 4 to solve the problem? Anybody give me a suggestion? Anybody? For this law number 4, can anyone be able to give me a good suggestion for this? What would be the thing to do if I'm solving this problem? Simplify. Actually, it says to simplify, right? When you're given a problem like this, don't forget, you'll be asked to what? To simplify. To simplify. So when you have a problem like this, it's going to ask you to what? To simplify this. So if you're asked to simplify this expression, what would it be? What would you have to do to get the solution for this? Anyone tell me? If I'm given this and I'm asked to simplify this, I want someone to tell me what I can do. Yes, tell me what I can do with this. If I'm asked to simplify this expression, that will be the appropriate question here to simplify this. Simplify. So how do you simplify an expression like this? For this example. Yes, what do I do? Can anyone tell me? So first you probably want to make sure you look at this as 2 to the 4th power. Okay, think of an invisible one there. Okay, very shortly we're going to say something about that. But if you have any number like x, this is going to be the same thing as x to the 4th power, where x is any real number. So this is a fact we know in mathematics. If you take any number, raise it to power 1, you get the same number. If you take 5, raise it to 4th power, you get 5. So any number raised to power 1, you get the same number. So that's why I can be able to include the 2, the what? Be able to include the 1 here. So what will this be? So this would be what? 2 to the 4th power times what? Based on this law of number 4. Times 2 times what? X to the 4th power times 2 times what? Y to the 6th power times what? Times 2. Okay, so with this now, I can be able to break down the problem completely. So this means what? That I can now be able to write this as what? If you take 1 times 2, what's 1 times 2?
2.
2. Take 2 now, raised to power 2. What's 4 times 2 here?
8.
So that will be x to what? 8 power. Now take 6 times 2 is what?
12.
So that would be y to the 12th power. So what is 2 to the 2nd power going to be?
4.
4. Excellent. So that would be 4. So finally the answer now will be 4. X to the 8th power. Y to the 12th power. answer for this problem, the solution for this problem. So that's log exponent number 4. That will be log exponent number 4. Okay. The other law we want to be able to look at idea is the idea of law of exponent number 5. That will be law of exponent. So we have law of exponent number 4 here. So now we want to look at law of exponent number what? 5. So let's look at now law of exponent number 5. So law of exponent number 4. So we want to go now and examine law of exponent number 5. So what's law of exponent number 5? What does it say? So law of exponent number 5 says, if you have x to the m, and we divide it by y to the n, and raise it to a power t, according to this law, this would be what? X to the m times t over what? Y to the n times t. So what will be an example for this law? What example will be appropriate? Well, an example for this, of course, would be if you're given something of this form. If you have 3y to the 6th power over z to the 8th power, and you're asked to raise it to power 3. Okay? So, if we take this 3 now, I think of 1 here. So we can distribute the powers inside the parentheses. I repeat, we can distribute the power what? Inside the parentheses. So this becomes what? 3 raised to what? 1 times 3, and then y, the 6th power, times 3, all over what? Z to what? 8 times 3. Okay? So, how do we finish this problem? What do we do? So, this now can be what? If we have 3 to 1 times 3, 3 to the 1st power times 3, 3 raised to the 1st power times 3, what would that be? Or 3 to the 3rd power. What's 3 to the 3rd power going to give us? What would be the answer? If we have 3 to the 3rd power, what would that be? 3 to the 3rd power would be what? Anybody? Take 3 raised to the 3rd power, what would it be? Yes, if you have the answer, give it to me. 3 raised to the 3rd power. 27. 27. Excellent. Excellent. 27. 27 is the answer, 27. Okay? So, what about take 6 multiplied by 3? Somebody else, Ms. Guerrera, what would that be? 6 times 3?
18.
18. So, that would be y to the 18th power. Very good, Ms. Guerrera of Houston, Texas. And what about 8 times 3. Somebody else, Ms. Tova. 8 times 3 is what?
24.
24. Thank you so much, Ms. Tova. So that will be z to the 24th power. Okay, so this is going to be the solution for this problem. This will be the solution for this problem. Okay? So you can see that you have to adopt a step-by-step way of solving the problem. Step-by-step method, step-by-step approach. And follow the law of exponent one by one, and you get everything right. Okay? So these are the 5 key laws of exponents.
But in addition to these five key laws of exponent, we also have what? Some three definitions that go with this law. Three what? Definitions that goes with this law. This presentation will not be complete without these three definitions that goes with these three laws of exponent. So what are the definitions? What are the three definitions connected to this law? What are they? So let us examine these three definitions that are connected to this laws of exponent. What are the three definitions? What are the three definitions connected to this law? We call this D sub 1. The definition 1 connected to this law of exponents, these five laws, says if you have x to the fourth power, as we have looked at that, that will give us x. Example, 2 to the fourth power is 2. Another example, if you have 0 to the fourth power, what will 0 be? What would that be, sorry? 0 to the fourth power will be what?
0.
0, excellent. So raise anything to the fourth power, you get the same thing. The other definition, we'll call that D sub 2. D sub 2, or definition 2, connected to this law, says something very significant. So what is that significant thing? D sub 2 says, if you take any number except the number itself, any number except that number itself, and raise it to power 0, you get 1. Except that number can now be what? 0. So we can say x can now be 0 here. So take any number, raise it to power what? You take any number, raise it to power what? 0, you get 1, but you can't raise 0 to power 0. So example, if you have 5 raised to power 0, what do you think that would be? Take any number raised to power 0. So if I take 5 raised to power 0, what would that be?
1.
Excellent. Lemon of Houston, Texas. So if you take any number raised to power 0, you get what? You get 1. Square root of 2 raised to power 0 will be what? What? Remember I said any number raised to power 0 will give you 1. So what square root of 2 raised to power 0 be?
1.
1. Excellent. Let's learn one again. Okay. The last one we want to look at is definition 3. So what does definition 3 says? Definition 3 says something very important. It says, if you take any number, take it to negative t power, as long as that number is not 0, you're going to get what? 1 over x to the t. Example. If you have something like this, x raised to negative 3 power, where x is not 0, what would that be? That would be what? 1 over what? X to what power? 3, that's it. 1 over x. Okay? So these are what we call five laws of exponents. Law number 1, 2, 3. Law number 4, law number 5. And what? Three definitions, what? Connected to what? The laws of exponents. We call this three key definitions. connected to what?
To the laws of what? Exponents.
I hope you have learned some key lessons about the laws of exponents today, and I hope that you can now be able to apply this law of exponents in solving exponents-related problems, and also be able to use it in solving problems involving polynomial algebraic expressions and other key areas of algebra. And thank you all for coming today to the MathCo Universe and the wonderful world of mathematics. Thank you very much.